So normally when you fly a kite, you care about the kite and not so much the string. But in my research, I'm interested in the dynamics of what the line is doing, whether it be a kite or a tethered balloon, offshore oil and gas platform underwater. There's cable dynamics in lots of different engineering systems. Anything with a cable moving around in the sky. You have changing tension along the line. You can get things like traveling waves. And that's what I'm trying to model. Even in a simple system like this, which is just a bathroom chain and a shower ring, you can get really complicated things going on. So if I just put the ring on the chain, so it's just free to fall off the end, like that. I'm just gonna put it back on. You can get complicated things on, because if I just drop this ring, failure is a part of life. It gets stuck. So you see that and you wonder, well, how does that work? And it's to do with the tether dynamics. So if I have this chain and this ring falls, I get a traveling wave going down the chain, like that. So when this ring is falling, it goes down the chain, and there's a wave following it down the chain. And when the wave gets to the end, there's whiplash, and this ring is going to fall into that hole and get stuck. So you can see that you can get complicated things even just on a short length like that. But when you have something that's longer, a balloon tether out in the environment, you have this long tether, you can still have these traveling waves going down the length of your cable. There you can see that wave traveling down. You're going to have changing tension. So the tension at the top, because of the self-weight, is a lot higher than the tension at the bottom. And not only that, if this is outside, you're going to have wind. So you're going to have drag on this tether. And you can imagine that normally you have tethers that are circular in cross-section, so something like this. And in terms of drag, it's really surprising that the drag on this circular cross-section is actually equal to the drag on this airfoil. So you can get a huge benefit if you can streamline the section in terms of drag, which will decrease the tension on your overall system. So my research has to do with, if you do change the cross-section of the tether, will it be stable? Can you even design something that would work? So I have an aerodynamic tether here, and I'm trying to model whether this would work. So I have this tether, and I'm going to discretize it into a bunch of tiny sections. So I'm going to break it up into small chunks, and that way I can model the elasticity and damping, the bending, torsion, all of those things. And I can also model sort of the changing parameters up the length. Say this is 20 kilometers long into the sky. So I'm going to have changing air density, changing wind speed. So I have a computer model to sort of model that behavior. But not only is that important, the actual cross-section of the tether is also important in terms of stability. So if I draw this cross-section out, I have a bunch of different centers. So on this airfoil, I'm going to have a center of mass, a center of tension, a shear center, which has to do with bending, and the aerodynamic center, which is where the lift acts. And depending on where these centers are with respect to each other is going to sort of dictate whether this cable is stable. So I have this 10 meter long length of the cable of aerodynamic tether, and manufacturing this is a project on its own. And you can see that this is the very first tether that's been manufactured, and it has some imperfections in it. You can see there, it hasn't quite filled in. So it's just a first attempt, but I think it would be quite good fun to string this up on a kite and have a go at flying it, see what it does. So now we have the aerodynamic tether section attached to the kite line, flying up there. And you can see that it alters the dynamics of the entire kite system quite a bit. This particular section isn't really manufactured in any way that it should be stable. It's just an extruded piece of sort of something aerodynamically shaped. So it does flutter around in the wind, it flips, and those are all of the problems that you could encounter if you had something that wasn't stable. But when it goes under tension, you can see that it sort of straightens out. And ideally, what you'd want to manufacture is something that you've played around with the cross-sectional properties so that it does align itself with the wind. So going out and flying kites for a PhD might seem like a bit of a laugh, but this is sort of the part that maybe makes a good film. What doesn't make a good film is me sitting in front of a computer doing a bunch of code or me writing out a bunch of equations. But that stuff's really interesting for me, and it's, you know, those equations that dictate whether something like this or an aerodynamic tether would be stable. And by the end of my PhD, hopefully I'll have a better idea of whether you can make an aerodynamic, stable tether. I think I might need some help first.
Still recording.